Assalamu alaikum 10th class, I am your teacher Ma'am Hira. This is our biology class in accordance to the morning schedule which is going well alhamdulillah. We are on unit number 11. The name of our unit is homeostasis and today's topic is excretion. Excretion is basically, you may have learned this term before, what is excretion? Excretion means the removal, to remove something which is not necessary, which has been used and which is not required for further procedures, is just excreted from the body, to give off something which is not required anymore. Excretion is of many kind. It also takes place in animals, in plants and in insects as well, in reptiles, etc. Everything which is on universe does excrete something which is not of its use. It includes anything. Today we are on our topic, which is excretion in plants related to the homeostasis. Plants respond to the environmental changes just like humans. Yesterday we have learned how humans respond to the environment when it is too cold outside or when it is too hot outside. Similar response is given by plants to them as well. Plants also respond when the internal conditions are changed. They have different mechanisms of homeostasis for the removal of oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen and other materials. Alright class? Next, our topic was removal of extra carbon dioxide and oxygen. How it is removed from the body of the plant? In daytime, during the day, the carbon dioxide produces during cellular respiration is utilized in photosynthesis. So guys, what in the day? During the day, as plants are going photosynthesis, it is used. It is not a waste product at the daytime. But when the night comes, at night, it is surplus because there is no utilization of that. It is removed from the tissues of the cell by diffusion. So you must understand this concept of day and night. So what happens in the day? In the day, carbon dioxide is used and at night carbon dioxide is excreted. In the day it is used for photosynthesis and at night it is just removed from the tissue by the help of diffusion. Alright, and what happens in leaves and young stems? Carbon dioxide escapes through stomata. What are stomata? We have read earlier. Stomata are the small pores like this. Just consider it as your leaf pattern. Stomata are present beneath the leaf, on the lower part of the leaf like this. Very small pores which we cannot see even with our naked eye. These are only visible with the help of a microscope. These small pores become open like this. They open and they just catch the sunlight, the carbon dioxide and anything required for that. The small pores become like this. These small pores which are present under the leaf, below leaf area, these are called the stomata. So they just absorb what is needed and they just excrete what is not needed. Next to that is oxygen. Oxygen is produced in mesophyll cells only during daytime as a byproduct of photosynthesis. After its utilization in cellular respiration, the mesophyll cells remove the extra amount of oxygen through stomata. And where does it go, the removed oxygen? Removed oxygen is used by humans for the process of breathing. We breathe with the help of oxygen. When there is no oxygen, it means there is no breathing. Breathing is the main source of living. So humans just live with the help of oxygen in which they breathe, and this oxygen comes from plants. And what on which plants do live? They live on carbon dioxide. And where does that come from? They come from human beings. We take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Just remember this phenomena. Humans do what? They take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. This phenomena is opposite to that of plants. Plants are in opposition with this. Plants give out oxygen for us and take in carbon dioxide, which is also from us. So this is just opposite to each other. We and plants are interconnected. We are closely linked to plants. That is why people are against the cutting down of trees. When there will be no tree, this means there will be no oxygen, and no oxygen means there will be no breathing, no humans, no human population will be able to live without breathing. That is why we have to plant tree. We have to just focus on the greenery for the green lives, just protect the green lives on earth. Otherwise, humans will also not be able to survive on this planet. Alright guys, this was all about the excretion and removal. What is removed during the day, what is removed during the night, what is utilized and what is produced. Alright 10th class, I hope you have understood my basic terms, excretion and the daytime and excretion at night time, and how humans and plants are interrelated in terms of the gaseous exchange. Thank you very much. Just remember these, protect yourself and your family from pandemic COVID-19 and learn these topics by home.